How does he feel about a 6'2" guy who's been in musicals playing him? Actually, I wouldn't ask that because I have to run as soon as I asked it.
There wasn't a lot to look forward to. So people began looking back. Nothing is more addictive than the past.
Hugh, it's lovely to talk to you about Reminiscence. I wish your character existed in real life in this so we could go back and explore our pasts. You've obviously achieved so much in your career. If you could go back and show your younger self one movie that you've done and say, look, that's me in the future, which one would it be?
So hard. So hard. Certainly some elements maybe of X-Men. Because the little kid of me that was called Sticks and Worm would go, that's me. I'm going to pick an English film, Les Mis, some moments from Les Mis, which I shot in London. It was something I'll never forget. 2, 4, 6, 1. If I could go back to the youngest version of myself, I would show him little bits, but not too much. I don't like knowing the future, but I just would want him to say to the younger version of me, chill out. Everything's going to be fine. Don't take everything so seriously. Enjoy the ride.
It's all going to be okay. It turns out pretty well. Having that power.
Something like that.
You've played such iconic characters. Whose past would you love to explore and go a little deeper into by putting them into this film?
Oh, certainly... there's a lot of questions about Wolverine's past that he would like to know, I would like to know. I actually did a lot of research around Barnum for The Greatest Showman, but that is a fascinating past and a fascinating story. This is where you wanna be. I would like to dig in a little more there. I'll start with those two.
Which questions would you want to ask Wolverine if you were there taking part in the Renaissance and you were speaking to him?
Wow, what would I like to ask him? How does he feel about a 6'2" guy who's been in musicals playing him? Actually, I wouldn't ask that because I have to run as soon as I asked it. I would like to ask him what he's scared of.
I mean, we need a whole prequel. This is a whole film. What Wolverine is scared of.
What a brilliant idea, Olivia.
I hope I'm going to get a producer credit. That's what I can get.
Minimum. Writing credit. Story by Olivia Marks.
I love it. I'm here for it. People are going crazy over you and Rebecca reuniting. How did it feel being the one fighting for her this time?
Yeah, it was so good. First of all, it was so good to have more than four scenes with her. She's so good in The Greatest Showman. You forget how few scenes she had in the movie. I think I did four or five scenes with her maybe, but in this, it was so great to have a lot more to do with her and to spend a lot more time with her. And as you say, to be fighting for her. But, you know, my character is completely obsessed with that character, with her falling in love and then she disappears and not knowing what the hell is going on. In truth, Rebecca is one of the funniest, most wicked people you'll ever met. I don't know if you've interviewed her, but she's wicked.
I have interviewed her before and she is hilarious. She is such a joy. She is. Well, I'm getting the rap, but thank you so much for talking to me. I know that you're doing a bunch of these, so I really appreciate it.
Thanks, Olivia. Take care. Thank you. It's Radio.